Welcome to Timing Closed Captions with Aegisub. This application is free and is available for Windows and Mac OS. We'll start by loading a transcript of the video we're going to caption. A transcript is a text file that has all the dialogue we're going to need to closed caption this video. We're going to closed caption a clip from George Romero's 1968 classic movie, Night of the Living Dead. Aegisub has only one way to import text files, and that's using the Open Subtitles command. Aegisub automatically parses the transcript into separate captions using the return at the end of every line or paragraph. We want to check a few things in preferences before we load the video clip we're using. In the Audio tab, the left click drag moves end marker should be turned on. Keyframe and dialogue mode should be turned off. Cursor time set to off. Keyframe in karaoke mode off. In the video tab, make sure automatically open audio when opening video is turned on. Now we can load our video clip. We're going to set two toggle to on in the main audio box. Automatically go to next line on commit. Auto scroll audio display to selected line. The audio waveform, if yours doesn't look like this, if it looks like this, that is the frequency waveform. We want amplitude. The height of these lines indicate the volume of the audio at these points. Where there's no audio or minimal audio, the waveform is very short. Where there's lots of audio, it's high. So the short areas are a good indication there's no dialogue in these sections. I'm going to go over a few of the keyboard and mouse shortcuts before we really get into this. On screen, you'll see visual indicators for when a left click has been used, a right click, and the keyboard shortcuts. Let's start with the mouse. I'm using a 3-button mouse, but we only need 2 buttons on it, the left and right buttons. We use the mouse buttons on the audio waveform to select the time and duration of when a caption plays. You can click and drag to make a selection like so. If you place your cursor over the end markers, you can drag them in and out. Or you can move the cursor and left click your mouse button and automatically set the start marker. And use the right mouse button to set the end marker. The scroll wheel zooms your time in and out. If you hold down the command key on Mac OS, you scroll the time back and forth. Use the control key on Windows to do the same. If you hold down the option key, you can move your selected time back and forth. So I'm going to make a new selection here. Pressing the R key will play that audio selection.
Does anyone up there know why we're being attacked?
I need to adjust the back of it a bit. Press the R key again.
Does anyone up there know why we're being attacked?
Move the endpoint in. Now, the R key plays the entire selection, but you'll get tired of listening to it over and over again. The E key will play the first half second of the selected audio.
Does anyone...
while the D key plays the last half a second.
Attack. Attack.
This way you don't have to listen to the entire audio clip over and over again. And it will also speed up the timing. Saving 1 or 2 seconds doesn't sound like much, but when you have dozens or hundreds of captions, it adds up. Now we have to commit our caption, which means essentially locking it in. You press the return key or the G key to do that. Now our next caption is loaded up for us.
What?
Now we know that has no dialogue by playing that, so I'm going to move the start marker. Try setting the end over there and play.
Whatever it isn't just happening here. It's...
move the end marker in with the right mouse key and commit it. And we can probably skip over to here to start the next selection. Move the back end. We use the audio waveform here to try and figure out where it starts and ends. Press the R key to play.
Some kind of mass murder. It's going on everywhere.
So I need to split that in half.
Some kind of mass murder. It's going on everywhere. Mass murder. Mass murder. Mass murder.
And we can lock that caption in. Move the endpoint in.
It's going on everywhere.
And that another caption locked in. Let's play this.
The radio said to stay inside.
Radio.
Play the last half second.
To stay inside. Stay inside.
So we have two overlapping captions almost, or two overlapping voices. You can hear her say radio before he finishes speaking.
The radio said to stay inside.
Radio.
We'll commit that one.
Radio.
And commit the next caption.
Radio upstairs. I heard a news bulletin. Radio upstairs. 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 I heard a news bulletin.
Commit.
There's a radio upstairs and you boarded us in down here? Here?
That one is locked in.
I know what I'm doing.
Again, I'm using the right and left mouse button to adjust the end markers rather than dragging that a little faster. Then trying to grab the end marker and move it in manually.
What did it say?
Nothing. They don't know anything yet. Nothing.
And another one locked in.
They don't know anything yet. Anything yet.
And another caption done and ready to lock in. Yeah, we know this is a long caption, so probably going to go on for at least a little bit.
There's mass murder everywhere and...
Scroll it over.
There's mass murder everywhere and people are supposed to look for a safe place to hide.
And another caption locked in.
Take the boards off that door.
And sometimes you get lucky and then you got a caption at the endpoint all ready to go for you. Lock it in.
We are staying down here, Helen.
Lock it in.
Harry, that radio is at least some kind of communication.
That's the great thing about the audio waveform. It makes it so much easier to see where the audio is. You can often see exactly where it starts and finishes.
If the authorities know what's happening, what they'll send... Happening what... Oh, what's happening? What's happening? What's happening? Happening what?
And we commit that one.
But they'll send people for us, so they tell us what to do.
And another caption locked in.
How are we going to know what's going on if we lock ourselves in this dungeon?
That's it. We're finished captioning this entire clip. If you want to see how the captions look, change the size of the video and hit the play button.
Does anyone up there know why we're being attacked?
Whatever it is, it isn't just happening here. It's some kind of mass murder. It's going on everywhere. The radio said to stay inside.
Radio?
Radio upstairs. I heard a news bulletin.
There's a radio upstairs and you boarded us in down here?
I know what I'm doing.
What did it say?
Nothing. They don't know anything yet. There's mass murder everywhere and people are supposed to look for a safe place to hide.
Take the boards off that door.
We are staying down here, Helen.
Harry, that radio is at least some kind of communication. If the authorities know what's happening, well, they'll send people for us so they tell us what to do. How are we going to know what's going on if we lock ourselves in this dungeon?
and the only thing left to do is to export your subtitles. I'm Mark Sweeney. Thanks for watching.